Good morning, students. In the previous class, in the same chapter, we had seen what are the various ways by which we can curb the population and why there is a necessity to curb the population and why the population is facing so much problems, means why the population is being diseased and what are the reasons for the population decrease or what are the reasons for the population increase. In the last previous class, we had seen that how the population should be curbed. Now we will see that there are so many diseases which are much more harmful than the HIV, that is AIDS. AIDS disease, it is more dangerous than the AIDS. So what are those diseases? Those are STDs. STDs can be also known as sexually transmitted diseases, venereal diseases, VD, reproductive tract infections, or it can also be known as the reproductive diseases, and it can also be known as STIs, that is sexually transmitted infections. STDs, similarly, STIs, that is sexually transmitted infections. So as we know that these are the various sexually transmitted diseases, means the various names for the sexually transmitted diseases. So basically, what organisms, which are the organisms which are causing these sexually transmitted diseases? Sexually transmitted diseases are caused by bacteria, viruses, fungus and protozoans, some of which is mentioned in your books will be explained over here. Like various, among the various reproductive transmitted diseases, some of the diseases are like gonorrhea. It's a bacterial diseases which are being transmitted through bacteria. There are some diseases which are transmitted by bacteria. Among those are gonorrhea, syphilis, chlamydiasis. Gonorrhea, since these three, all the three are being caused by the bacteria, what is the causative organism? That is, which is the bacteria which is causing all the three diseases? Gonorrhea, as we know, it is caused by the organism bacteria, that is Neisseria gonorrhoeae. Syphilis, Treponema pallidum. And chlamydiasis, again, chlamydia, from the name itself, Chlamydia trachomatis. So Neisseria gonorrhea, this, it is being found in the, means sores are being present in the urethra and the genital regions, in the even the throat, in the males as well as females. Apart from that, it is also found in the female vagina. It is also being formed, gonorrhea. The symptoms are ulcers, pus, swollen nodes. Then second is the syphilis. Syphilis is caused by the bacteria Treponema pallidum. Syphilis is caused in three stages: primary stage, secondary stage, and tertiary stage. Primary stage, it is the first form of the infection, means the infection will take place. So in this, the ulcers will be formed. No, it will be swollen, but it will be painless. Painless ulcers will be formed on the outer region of the genital area. Then in the secondary stage, when syphilis reaches the secondary stage, means it goes undetected. If it goes undetected, in the secondary stage, it will cause, pus will form, start to form in those ulcers. Pus will start forming, discharge will take place, and the person will have hair loss, fever will take place, mucosal lining will be affected. Then in the tertiary stage is the most infected stage. It can also lead to the immobilization of the limbs, mean a person will not be able to move properly. The groin nodes also will be affected. So syphilis means it has to be treated in the primary stage itself. If at all it is not detected in the primary stage, in the later stage it will become more infectious and it will cause more harm to the patient. Third disease, a bacterial disease, is chlamydiasis. It is caused by the bacteria Chlamydia trachomatis. So it is formed in the trachoma and it is formed in the epithelial cells of the urogenital tract. It is formed in the urogenital tract. Again, there will be itching sensation, discharge will be there, and nodes will be swollen on the groin region. Groin nodes will be affected. These three are the diseases which are caused by bacteria, that is sexually transmitted infection, sexually transmitted diseases which are formed by bacteria. So now we will see the diseases which are caused, sexually transmitted diseases which are caused by the viruses, which is mentioned in your book. There are so many sexually transmitted diseases that are being formed by bacteria, viruses. The thing which is mentioned will be, it will be discussed over here. Bacteria, like, so one is the genital herpes, then genital warts. Then AIDS, hepatitis B. Genital herpes, the causative organism, as I told, all are being caused by the viruses. The virus which is responsible for genital herpes is herpes simplex virus. Again, it is found in the genital region, so it will cause itching sensation, discharge will be there, nodes will be swollen, tumor like growth will be there, but it will be painless tumor like growth in herpes simplex virus, that is genital herpes. Then genital warts, it is being caused by human papilloma virus. It is commonly called as HPV. HPV is very infectious. So it also causes pain, itching sensation, discharge will be there, fever will be there by the genital warts. Earlier the warts will appear as outgrowths. It's external outgrowth on the genital regions, but it will be painless. After that, the warts will be filled with pus, and it will also cause discomfort, and sores will also be formed. Sometimes what happens, suppose a person is being already affected by genital warts, a lady, and if at all she is pregnant, and when she gives birth to the child is infected to the warts, the ulcers, the sores which are present in the genital areas, and the child is heavily infected by those areas, by those regions. So human papilloma virus. Then AIDS, we know the causative organism of AIDS, human immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV. See, from the name itself it is mentioned, human immunodeficiency virus, that means immunity is being affected. Like earlier we had seen in the bacterial infections, the incubation period will be 2 to 5 days, 80 to 90 days, mostly 3 months means the incubation period will be there, because sometimes the disease is asymptomatic, like it will be asymptomatic, but after that it will develop the symptoms, and to develop symptoms it takes so many months, sometimes years. That happens in the case of HIV. It can take place in 6 weeks times also one can get, or sometimes it takes 10 years for the disease to be caught. Why? Because there will be a diarrhea like symptoms in the patient, weight reduction will be there, prolonged diarrhea, weight reduction, then prolonged fever, means every time, even where there is no cause, no cough and cold, but the person is causing fever is happening to that person again and again, even though their person is taking antibiotics also, but again the person is having recurrent fever. So that is one of the symptoms. Weight reduction will be there, the diarrhea like symptoms will be there. So that is human immunodeficiency virus. Then hepatitis B virus, that is called also known hepatitis B, it is called was caused by HBV, that is hepatitis B virus. Hepatitis, we know the various vaccines are being provided for hepatitis nowadays. Why? It is much more harmful than the HIV AIDS. Why? Although we are saying that there is no cure for HIV, although there is a vaccine for hepatitis, but why hepatitis is considered still more harmful? Because if it is undiagnosed, if it is diagnosed, there is no problem, it can be treated. But if it goes undiagnosed, it will lead to various problems. Why? Because jaundice will take place. Because of this HBV virus, jaundice will take place, fever will take place, abdomen means there will be abdominal pain, stomach pain will be there. And if it is not treated, that means if it goes untreated, that's what I was saying, that if it goes undiagnosed, then it will lead to liver cirrhosis. The later stage will be liver cirrhosis or the cirrhosis of the liver or liver failure. Means the person will meet his death. So that those are the various, these four are the various diseases which are caused by the virus, that is sexually transmitted infections. Now one more is what we have discussed, it that it is caused by fungus also and it is caused by protozoa also, which is mentioned in your book. Like these are all mentioned in the virus. In the fungus you have been given candidiasis, fungal STIs, fungal sexually transmitted infections or sexually transmitted diseases which are caused by fungus. So the disease is candidiasis, causative organism is Candida albicans. Candida albicans. The symptoms for candidiasis will be, there will be itching. There will be itching sensation in the urethra in case of male, and uterus, vagina. The vagina also the sensation will be there, itching sensation will be there. Then various discharge will be observed from the vagina. A discharge will be white in form and there will be pain. And when they will pass urine, either the male or the female, if it is passing urine means they will feel a burning sensation. It is not only limited to the genital areas, it is formed also in the throat, mouth. These candidiasis, it can occur in the mouth also, it can occur in the throat also. So Candida albicans, this can be treated. If it is detected, it can be easily treated. Then protozoan STIs. Protozoan STIs, trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis. The disease is known as trichomoniasis. It is a protozoan reproductive tract infectious disease. It is caused by Trichomonia vaginalis. See, from the name itself, it is given vaginalis. So it is very clear that it is, this disease is found in the females. So males are the carrier of these diseases. Trichomoniasis, the male person is the carrier. And since it's a reproductive tract infection or it is the sexually transmitted disease, when it is transmitted to the female, it develops in the vagina of the female. Again, the discharge, vaginal discharge will be there, pain will be there, swelling will be there, a burning sensation in urine will be there. Only different between a fungal disease, Candida albicans, when it happens in the reproductive tract area, and the Trichomonia vaginalis, when it is found in the vagina of the female, the difference is that in both the discharge occur. But here in Candida, the discharge will be frothy-like, white frothy-like discharge, whereas in Trichomonia vaginalis, a protozoan STDs, the discharge will be thick discharge. There will be pain during bleeding also, and after menstruation also there will be bleeding, but the discharge will be greenish white in color. Because of the color, it can be differentiated that it is a protozoan STDs and it is a fungal STIs. So that will be the difference between a fungal STIs and the protozoan STIs. Again, the incubation period will take place to 1 to 2 weeks, here also 10 to 12 days. So by that, if the antibiotics are taken and if the medicines are taken on time, if it is taken, then it can be easily treated. What are the reasons for all the reproductive tract infections, whether it is by bacteria, whether it is by virus, whether it is by fungus, or whether it is by protozoan. Basically, there are three things which has to be followed. First, means having single partner, or means if the coitus takes place, it should take place with a single partner. We should avoid multiple partner. Should avoid multiple partner or unknown partner. And if at all it is taking place, if a union is taking place, then condom should be used. If at all the union is taking place, then precaution should be observed. That is, use of contraceptives should be taken, means condom should be used, not at all contraceptives that the female is using. Contraceptives should not be used. That is, condom should be used so that the semen should not reach the vagina. It should not reach it, so that the infection will not occur. And third and foremost, means it is the most important, if the person has encountered the disease, means there is no other way, the person has got that disease, means they should visit the doctor, and just visiting the doctor does not serve the purpose. The treatment should be completed. A complete treatment for STDs should be taken place, because the incubation period, as I said, it varies. So if the person is rejecting the treatment, means if the person is withdrawing from the treatment, which is required for, suppose, 14 days treatment or a 1 month treatment with medicines is being there, and the person withdraws from that, like 7 weeks, and they discontinue the treatment. So what will happen? Because the incubation period is a prolonged period. So what will happen? The disease will again resurface. It is not that you will get relief from the disease. A temporary relief will be there, but the disease will again resurface. So when if suppose a person has encountered the disease, they should go for doctor, they should complete the treatment. Then only they can be easily, they will overcome reproductive tract infections or the STDs. I am just mentioning all the STDs apart from HIV, because AIDS, the remedy has not been found till now. Prevention is only the method by which AIDS can be prevented, but it is not cured. It can be prevented. Now, after this, we will see the various ways by which the couple can have children. Which couple can have children? Normal couple? No. Those couples who are infertile. Why do you say that an infertile couple? How do you term a couple as infertile? Suppose a couple is cohabiting with each other, and even after 1 year or 2 year of cohabiting with each other without using any protection, but they are unable to have a baby, so means the couple is termed as an infertile couple. Even after having unprotected coitus for 1 year or 2 year, they are unable to conceive a child, then those couples will be known as the infertile couple. Earlier it was a taboo, but now there is no such things, because there are various scientific techniques by which the couple will be able to have a child of his own. So those technologies by which the couple will be able to have the child of her own is known as ART. ART. What is ART? ART, assisted reproductive technology. Assisted reproductive technology means all the technology, means which is performed outside the body of the person, a male or the female, which is being performed outside, and then these help to conceive the child. So such a technology is known as assisted reproductive technologies. So what are the assisted reproductive technologies? There are various technologies. We will see one by one. What are those? The various ART technologies. ART, assisted reproductive technologies. Common among them is IUI, that is intrauterine insemination. Intrauterine insemination. What is intrauterine insemination is that suppose the male is unable to have sperms, means suppose the male is having sperms but the sperm count is very low. So what is being done in that case, the semen of the male, that is the biological father of the child or the partner of the female, the semen is being collected. If they want the child of their own, either the semen is being collected, and or if the semen count is very low, means even after collection also the count is very low, because for one egg you need at least 10,000 to 1 lakh sperms. So if that sperm is not being met, so what will happen? A healthy donor can also donate the semen, and that semen is being transferred through to the uterus, through the vagina. It is being implanted by the catheter. By that it is implanted, the semen is being implanted inside the uterus through the vagina, and then the following it will reach the fallopian tube, it will make the egg, and the zygote will again descend towards the uterus, means a normal pregnancy will take place. Only thing is that the semen has to be transferred to the fallopian tube. It is being transferred by the vagina to the uterus, means through the uterus it will reach the fallopian tube and the normal pregnancy will take place. That is known as the IUI, intrauterine insemination. Or else we can go for in vitro fertilization. What does in vitro fertilization means? In vitro fertilization means outside the body of the female. What is being happening? The ova is being collected from the female and the sperm is being collected by the male, and these two are being fused and it is implanted in the fallopian tube. Means fallopian tube at the which stage? At the 8-celled stage, that is the blastomere stage. Means the zygote has formed, it has fused and the zygote is formed. Sometimes what is happening, the fused zygote is being transplanted in the fallopian tube, or the 8-celled blastomere, that zygote, that is being directly planted in the uterus. In the both ways IVF will take place, that is in vitro fertilization, and further division will occur in the uterus itself, that is in vitro fertilization. Next is the zift, that is zygote intra fallopian tube. Like in vitro fertilization, what we had seen in the 8-celled stage, blastomere stage, it is implanted in the uterus. That is in vitro fertilization. In zygote intrafallopian tube means the zygote is implanted in the fallopian tube. The zygote, first it is being fused in the laboratory conditions, then it is fused and it is implanted in the fallopian tube. From the fallopian tube, it will descend down and it will implant itself in the uterus, and further development will take place in the uterus. That is zygote intrafallopian transfer. Then ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Like in IVF, we need at least 10,000 to 1 lakh eggs, but in intracytoplasmic sperm injection, what is happening? It only one sperm is being transferred to the egg. In the central focal point of the egg, the sperm is being transferred. So there is 75 to 85 chances that zygote will be formed. So that is known as intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Mean the sperm is directly transferred to the focal point of the egg, one sperm, and the further development will take place. Next is the gift, that is gamete intrafallopian transfer. What is gamete intrafallopian transfer is that some females, they are having problem in the ova, means there is very little ova in the females. So what takes place is that there are some females, means the younger ladies, what is happening in foreign countries nowadays, they are donating their ova, because there is a hormone, that is HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, HCG. What is the function of HCG? Human chorionic
gonadotrophins. Gonadotrophins.
So what is the function of the HCG is that it will stimulate the ova to produce more eggs. So when the HCG is being injected in the female, they will produce more eggs. The female who can normally they can produce more eggs means they are a healthy female, and hence when the HCGs are also injected, they will be able to produce still more eggs. So when the more eggs are being produced, these eggs are being harvested from the healthy female, and these eggs, these are being transferred to the ampulla isthmus junction of the fallopian tube in those females who are unable to produce healthy ova, or suppose what happens is the fimbria is unable to catch the ova from the ovum, from the ovary, they are unable to catch the ovum, fimbriae. So what is taking place, those females are being given gamete, that is ovum is being provided, and that is being implanted in the fallopian tube. Either the ovum will be transplanted to the fallopian tube and sperm injection can be given, by that the zygote will be formed and then the further development will take place, or else that ova, these takes place sometimes. What happens, the fallopian tubes are blocked, some people don't have a good growth of the fallopian tube, fimbria doesn't able to catch. So in those cases gift is happening, as a gift is like a gift, because they are giving their ovum to the female who is otherwise not having ovum. Okay, so by this way also the gamete intrafallopian transfer takes place, means the gamete is being transferred to the fallopian tube, that is the ovum is being transferred to the fallopian tube, and when it meets the sperm by natural conditions, means by natural union or else by embryo transfer or else by intrauterine insemination, then also the fertilization will take place. So these are the methods, IVF, ZIFT, ICSI, GIFT, even embryo transfer, ET, embryo transfer, it is also like artificial insemination, means artificially insemination will be done and the embryo is being formed outside and then the embryo is being transferred in the uterus. So by these methods, the person, the couples who are unable to have a child of their own, they can have child, and now they won't be treated as a childless couple. So these are the various methods, various means by which the couple can have the children of their own. Lastly, one topic needs to be covered is that MTI. What is MTI? That is medical termination of pregnancy. Medical termination of pregnancy. This medical termination of pregnancy takes place in the first trimester, that is first 3 months of pregnancy. If MTP is being practiced, then the mother will be, there will be no harm to the mother in the first trimester. It takes place, it is legalized, government has legalized, just because sometimes what is happening, the child, the embryo, the child is not having a normal chromosome. So by that way, it is advisable, the doctor themselves advised to abort the child. So medically, they are being prescribed to abort the pregnancy. Sometimes what happens in the case of victims, the victims, those who have been sexually harassed, they are accidentally, they get pregnant. So by that way also, that's an unwanted pregnancy. For that reasons also, the court themselves declare an MTI, that is medical termination of pregnancy, so that they would not cause emotional trauma to the patients. So this is MTI, medical termination of pregnancy. Lastly, a last topic of this chapter is that how the examination will be done for breast cancer. How the examination should be done for the breast cancer. See, like in the breast is divided into four quadrants, five quadrants actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the fifth quadrant. After 1 week of menstruation, either the patient should lie down or they should stand, and from the opposite, suppose they have to go for this quadrant, they should use the arm of this side, and they should check the lumps in this quadrant, and arm of this side, and they should check the lumps for these quadrants, either in the lying position or they should stand, and then they should observe for the lumps. If any lumps are being formed, they can be treated in the early stage, and hence breast cancer will be avoided. Similarly, one more thing is the cervical cancer. It takes place in the cervix and the causative organism is HPV, that is human papilloma virus. This takes place in females, with the, those who are of the reproductive age. So if it is cervical cancer nowadays, vaccine is there, that is the it is being provided to the girls who are who did not attain menstruation, means they do not attain maturity till 13 years. The cervical cancer, for the cervical cancer HPV vaccine can be taken. Or otherwise, if the person has encountered cervical cancers, so pap smear will be taken, various scans are being done. By that, they can be detected, cervical cancer can be detected, and it can be treated in the early stage. Basically, what I wanted to say is that all the things, if their symptoms are known to you, we should approach the doctor, and if the symptoms are there, the doctor will explain and the doctor will advise. We should not be ourselves, we should not claim to be a doctor, because we should go to a practice practitioner. And they will tell as to what treatment should be taken. And if the treatment is taken and the treatment is completed, then there is no chances of any further complications. It can be nipped in the bud stage. So children, I hope you have understood this chapter. Thank you.